word of God. John chapter 8. If you have a Bible, please open to John chapter 8. I'm going to read this in English so I can practice my English. But Jesus went to the Mount of Olives early in the morning. He came again into the temple, and all the people were coming to him, and he sat down and began to teach them. The scribes and Pharisees brought a woman caught in adultery, set her in the center of the court. They said to him, "Teacher, this woman has been caught in adultery in the very act. Now, in the law of Moses, it commanded us to stone such a woman. What then do you say?" They were saying this, testing him, so that they might have grounds for accusing him. But Jesus stooped down and with his finger wrote on the ground. But when they persisted in asking him, he straightened up and said to them, "He who is without sin among you, let him be the first to throw a stone at her." Again he stooped down and wrote and began to go and wrote on the ground. When they heard it, they began to go out one by one, beginning with the older ones. And he was left alone and the woman where she was in the center of the court. Straightening up, Jesus said to her, "Woman, where are they? Did no one condemn you?" She said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said, "I do not condemn you either. Go, from now on, sin no more."
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. John 8 ayat 1.
Yeah.
Sampai apa ya? Sampai 11.
God. And I want you to learn lessons from this story. So as we retell the story, this is the woman caught in adultery. This is Jesus. An Iban Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I am the evil people. So here is this woman. She is a sinner. But the people in this story did not care for her soul. They had no love for her. They wanted to judge her. They didn't love Jesus either.
Orangnya pun tak rindu ke Jesus.
Watch their anger.
Pedaklah pengeringat sidak ya.
They take her and they throw her to the ground.
Sidak yang ambil orang itu kita dia lutikau.
They kick her.
Lendang ya, lendang ya. Itu
yang kita.
And they spit at her.
Duh, ya muntah mereka.
And they judge her.
Ya hukum ya baru.
She has been beaten.
Ya dipalung lagi.
They don't care for her. And they are beating her. And they are cursing her. And, scream. Louder.
Like somebody just took your favorite outfit and tore it up.
Yeah.
That is somehow sick. Okay, anyway.
So they are, and so they have now cursed her, and now they bring her and they drag her. And they bring her to the only one who can help her. But this is not their concern. In that day, by the time she would have been brought to Jesus, they would have spit on her.
Yeah.
They would have kicked her. They would have slapped her. And beaten and bruised, they would have dragged her. But not by the arm like I did. They would have grabbed her by the hair. And they would have left her there and pointing down at her. They looked at
Jesus.
And they said what their plan was. We are going to stone her and kill her. Are you going to try to stop us?
And
think about this. They want to do it for two reasons. If Jesus says, no, don't kill her, then they will say, you are breaking the law, and now we will kill you and her.
Jesus.
He said, and if Jesus had said, yes, you are right, she would have died, and they would have said, see, we are important, and you must listen to us and not to Jesus.
Jadi ini semua Jesus marah. Abu Noah menginduk tu. Jadi sudah kalau marah kita rempu. Kami itu lebih besar dari Tuhan Yesus. Jesus ingat kejakuk kami.
And so here is this woman beaten and bruised and afraid.
Jadi induk tu mereka ibadat tahu ia pedias, ia takut.
But what was she thinking? Let us ask her. Go ahead. Yep.
Yeah. I was reading the story.
Yeah, macam cerita tadi.
And trying to put myself in her shoes many, many times.
Sebetulnya tadi berapa kali sudah macam cerita ke macam tu kata lak ke oleh nama tu kena saya hidupnya. Nama dia kau engkau tadi pun sebab kau ngai hidupnya.
And she must have felt very, very scared.
Yo, mesti yang ngah saya ketakut.
Not just that, not scared. Not just scared to be hurt, but to die.
Okay, mati ketegal dipalukan mati. Okay, takut ketegal dipalukan, takut ketegal dia dekat dibunuh.
But to die a horrible death.
Tak mati tip malu pedis.
To die in a lot of pain.
Mati buat dalam pedis tip kuat tip besar. Oh, pedis tip ini kamu buat ibadnya.
And
mati tip balak pedis.
And as she was dragged to Jesus.
Maya induknya ditarik dengan Jesus.
When she was taken from that place.
Maya induknya diambil dari tempat yo.
She was afraid. She was afraid that of all the times that probably she was with that man that she was with, she was always afraid that one day she was gonna get caught.
Jadi ia mesti duitik tengah soi takut terubah ia takut orang ia takut ke orang kenggawai beleman tadi. Oh kedua ia takut megok ngai ke pengawok ia ke butang jadi ditemu ramai.
And when she got caught,
Maya ia kena tangkap.
You know when you got caught doing something bad, remember your heart sinks.
Kini asai kita ditemu orang nangkap ditangkap orang adu tai ti madu jai ke dilalai ke kita.
Yes, and your heart sinks.
Kini hati kita itu penyak deh.
And she doesn't know what to do and she's so afraid and then she is hit and she is beaten and spat on.
Okay, dah tadi bisik madah ke ya ngasok kan semina ingat saya ketakutan yang mesti ngasai medis tubuh ya diludah oh ya lalu dipalu ditendang.
But I feel like she felt she maybe she deserved.
Enggak kadang nak induknya mesti berundang oh aku patut menerima hukum.
I'm sure she knew what she was doing.
Ya laban yang nemu pengawal kayak dadu yang tadi salah.
Maybe felt like she deserved the treatment she was getting. And I feel like she was ready to die. She knew that death was coming and she deserved it.
Jadi nemu pemati dekat datai nak labo lagi jadi yang saya ke yo aku patut mati aku layak patut mati.
And as she now has come to the conclusion she deserves to die.
Dia tu dah yang madah dah menganggap kesimpulan dari pu yang madah aku dah patut mati.
The strangest thing happens.
Utai tinggi lainnya di.
Jesus is asked once again.
Jesus tanya sidak ya.
Should we not kill her?
Patut kena kita bunuh hidup tu.
But what does he do?
Nama apa kata Jesus?
He kneels down.
Ya lalu atun ketuk deh.
And he begins to write in the ground.
Ya lalu nulis tunjuk jari ya.
No one knows what he wrote.
Kita nak nemu nama tu nak ketulis Jesus ne?
We can only guess.
Kita minat boleh nangko.
But they are very angry at Jesus. Why is he not answering? This is a trap. We want to kill her. We want to kill
Jesus.
Why is he not answering? Why is our plan not working? And all of a sudden, maybe they look at the ground. And they see what he is writing. Maybe the first one sees Jesus writing greed. And when he sees greed, he says, this is something I struggle with in my own life.
Tulis amuk tu kerana tu deh aku tu amuk Tuhan.
And another one sees and he looks and he says, he is writing jealousy.
Dan dia tadi sebengkah orang mendak, tulisannya mendak, jealous orang tu.
I am always jealous.
Aku jealous.
And the next one looks down.
Yang orang buka lagi mendak buat anak.
And he sees his sin.
Mendak dosa ya ditulis.
And Jesus is just writing.
Jesus semina nulis saja.
Or maybe Jesus is writing the new story he has for her. Maybe he's beginning to write in the book the new story for this woman. The Bible tells us there is a book about your life. God is writing in that book.
Amen.
And God is writing a beautiful future. But he is also writing a terrible future. You have the choice. What will your story be? Will it be blessing? Or will it be a curse? Maybe the woman saw him writing this story of her life.
Namanya cerita penghidup yang ditulis Jesus.
But again, they're yelling at Jesus.
Tangsi tak yaki nyeruah ngi Jesus.
Get up.
Angkat tuan.
Tell us your answer.
Padahnya kami nama jawab sawat tuan.
And Jesus rose.
Dan Jesus selalu angkat.
And he answered them.
Jesus selalu jawab si dia.
But not what they were expecting.
Tangsi tak enak nyangkut nama kita pada Jesus.
He looked at them and said.
Jesus melihat ngi si dia lalu mata.
You who is without sin, you cast the first stone.
Tidak nuan nak kalau berdosa nuan menikau batu dulu.
And he went back to writing.
Sudahnya Jesus nulis baru buat anak.
One by one they listen.
Siku sudah ninggal.
Your Bible says the oldest left first.
Buku kudus mada orang ti pemandu tuai ninggal ke tempatnya dulu. Apa ada cerita kita tadi?
Those of us that are old.
Orang ti tuai baku kita itu baku yo tu.
We know all the sins we have committed.
Kita nemu semua dosa kita.
And God has given us wisdom.
Tak Tuhan beri kita penemu.
And humility.
Lah kita baru hati.
My brother and I are similar age.
Hey.
We are old men, but we are still strong.
Hey,
hallelujah! We still have a fire inside of us. But we know that before we open our mouth, we should think before we speak. And the Bible says, one by one, from the oldest to the youngest, they dropped their stones and they went away. Do exactly what I'm going to describe. And the woman suddenly rose to her feet. And she was trembling with fear.
Dia takut, dia getar-getar takut.
Tremble. And she looked around and everyone was gone.
Dan induknya pun melihat ada beberapa orang gitu dia.
It was just her and Jesus.
Mina iyo ngau Jesus sejak ditinggal sama dia.
I can't imagine what she was thinking.
Nama nak tadi rundi yang induk tu tadi.
Is the holy teacher going to kill her?
Pengajar di kudus tu Jesus kayak tadi dekat bunuh ya.
Is the one who is called the Son of God going to judge her?
Karena anak tu dikumbai, anak Allah kalau tu dekat bunuhnya.
Jesus arose from writing in the ground.
Jesus angkat udah yang nulis buat anak.
And he turned and faced the woman.
Lalu ia melihat dengan induknya.
And he asked her a question.
Jadi ia nanya induk tu.
Has anyone condemned you?
Besi orang dah Bisi orang udah bersalah kan Wan? Bisi orang udah hukum Wan?
And she said, no one, Lord.
Yang mana nada orang hukum aku.
Listen to this.
Dengar kita tetap.
Oh, my brothers and my sisters.
Arab itu semua menyadari dalam Tuhan.
Let all the world hear Jesus' answer.
Apa nak semua dunia dengar Jesus tu jawab?
God, who had come to earth.
Tuhan itu dah nurun ke dunia.
He looked at her.
Yang Jesus mendak ngino.
And said to her.
Mendak ngino.
I do not condemn you either.
Aku pun nak hukum Tuhan.
Today we hear that voice.
Maksud itu kita dengar ke nyawa Tuhan.
We hear the voice by the Holy Spirit speaking to our hearts.
Dengar hari jaku Roh Kudus tiap jaku ngino.
But she heard His voice with her own ears.
Sang induk tu dengar jaku Tuhan ngena pendiang yang.
Oh hallelujah!
Amen.
I wonder what she thought.
Nama nak rundeng induk.
Let us ask her.
Arang kita nanya eh barang.
What did you think when Jesus said that?
Nama terundeng nuan tadi nama Jesus madahnya. Jesus madahnya nak diukur, diampun.
Totally. You can go as long as you want and say it.
So, the Bible doesn't say how many times she committed adultery, but.
Yeah, buku dosa dari si mandah berapa kali udah buta.
As in how many times she cheated on her husband? She has cheated or she was with the man?
Nah, buku dosa dari mandah berapa kali udah berbulok ke laki ya ngorok ukai.
But that was not the first time.
Mm-hmm. Bapak penemunya tu utai keterubah kali ya bu, utai keterubah kali ya kalau buta. Idah banyak kali dah buta lah.
I believe that when she was in the room with the man, she was very anxious when she was about to commit her sin.
Jadi mayo ya bu, ya buta ngau laki tu, kerana pada dalam bilik tu ia ngasai ke gago amat. Mesti pengen kene kepada dia. Ia kok. Ya, besi pengingin kok ngadu ke ulah pijai.
She lived in fear for her life.
Ya, mereka besi ngasai ketakut oh, pada dalam hidup ya.
Not just with her consequences with God.
Bukan ketegal, ya bukan ketegal penyalahnya ditemu Tuhan.
Like as if, what would Jesus do if he found out?
Kerana ya berunding, berkenin tidak gamal Tuhan kita nemu. Kerana ya besi berunding, kena itu asai Tuhan, ti Tuhan nemu penyalah aku tu.
And if so, I think she felt like she was so far into her sin that she felt like she deserved the consequences that was coming.
Jadi ia sudah terlalu dalam buat dalam dosa. Nya kebuah tadi, ulah ia iyo uli nrimo namo akibat dosa tekada dawo kaya ni tadi.
I want you to put yourself in her shoes.
Uji kita sebab uji kita nak lamo kita ngengkah ke diri pos sebab kau ini kebuta.
Feel her guilt and her shame.
Rasai ke rasai bersalah ni bisik ne rasai takut bisik.
To feel her fear of death.
Bisa takut ke mati mereka lepas adat sidap dia adat orang lihatnya tiada tiada butang mereka ditukuk nak batu mati.
I don't think she wanted to continue sinning.
Ya, engkau kadang nak induk butangnya engkau terus berdosa.
She was looking for a way out.
Ya, kadang nak ia bisik kau ingat jalan keluar dari dosa.
But she doesn't know where to look.
Tangan ada mu berkenai kau lepas dari hari dosa.
So when she was dragged to Jesus,
Maya ia ditarik oleh Jesus.
She felt so exposed.
Ia ngasai kita dari empu di pedang orang main.
So naked.
Asai kita telanjai, lapa orang magang betul yo.
She wasn't ready to be seen by Jesus.
Ia pedang, ya, ia pedang bersedia aku di pedang orang main wah ngau Jesus betul.
I think of the way Jesus spoke to her.
Ya berunek apa kini nak gamal Jesus berjaga pada itu.
And if you know Jesus,
ketik Tuhan Allah Jesus.
You know he is so kind.
Tuhan Jesus tu mana?
And he's so lovely.
Ya penuh dengan pengerindu.
And I think he was a big man, like a big Mediterranean man.
Kadang nak gamal yang besar deh, pakar
dia. And we always see pictures of him with long hair.
Selalu kita berarti ke gambar Jesus, bising gua panjang.
But when you know someone that is of authority,
nanti kita kita nemu ratu bising penuh kuasa.
You feel scared, right?
Kita like, ngasai kita takut, oh, berarti bising pengawal yeah. Tinggi, apa gua yeah. Baby datang takut kita nangis, kan? Bising perasaan takut kita.
And so when Jesus was talking to her, when they were finally alone.
Maya setuai, udah orangnya semua, udah orang ke bedawa, kayaknya lari magang. Semina iyo nggak Jesus saja ditinggal.
I believe she fell to her feet.
Ya.
To his feet. She fell to his feet.
Ya, karena iyo lalu sungkur ke tanah kian.
After he said those words to her.
Udah Tuhan Yesus nyebut Yakub nyakayo.
Because why?
Namo kebuah.
Because those words that he said.
Lapan Yakub kepada Tuhan Yesus.
Set her free.
Ngelepas kayo.
Because of all the guilt that she has been feeling.
Lapan semua penyalah kepada saya.
The shame.
Pemalu.
That Jesus told her. He didn't say it in the words, but what he meant was that he loves her.
Tadi pun Jesus ada yang madah. Aku rindu kenuatan cara Jesus madah nanti ya. Cara Jesus berjakuk nanti ini tu madah kan. Aku rindu kenuatan.
And that he forgives her.
Jadi Jesus ngampun ke ini tu nanti.
And that she is a free person.
Jadi dia tu ini tu orang nanti lepas kan.
But he told her to go.
Jesus ngasuh ini tu ngupuat nuan.
But sin no more.
Anak kita berdosa.
Amen.
To do it no more.
Anak kita berdosa.
Amen.
But he tells her in a loving way.
Tuhan Yesus madah engkau cara tip lembut cara tip.
Because that is who Jesus is.
Lepasnya baik Tuhan Yesus kita. Ya lembut. Ya nak nganu kita.
Sure, he is a man of authority.
Ya tanya apa Yesus tu sebagai Tuhan yang mesti kuasa.
But he is loving.
Dia nerlah.
He sees you.
Dia melakukan.
He knows your pain.
Dia melakukan.
Yes.
He knows what you have done.
Dia nemu tengah
dalam yes.
He knows who you were in the past.
Dia nemu siapa tuan support.
And he knows what you are doing now.
Dia nemu nama tengah
dalam yes.
But he says.
Tang Jesus mata.
I forgive you.
Pengampun kenapa?
And go and sin no more.
Anak
yes, amen.
Hallelujah.
But that does not mean.
Bukan artinya tadi.
You can go and sin.
Nuan boleh berdosa lagi.
And you come back.
Nuan nanti baru ngaji Tuhan.
And you ask for forgiveness.
Minta pengampun dari Tuhan baru.
That's not what he wants you to do.
Kayaknya, kayaknya kita dah suap Tuhan kita.
He wants you to remember who you are, who He has made you to be.
Tuhan, tu cara Tuhan madah kita ingat kenuan waktu tu make buah nuan dia.
Amen.
And to sin no more.
Anak-anak itu berusaha.
Jesus knows that deep down.
Tuhan Yesus semua berdalam hati kita.
You want Him to heal you.
Sorry?
You want Him to heal
okay.
you.
Okay, yang demo pada lama tinggal, nuan kau Tuhan ngerai.
It is a desire that God has placed in our hearts.
Pengingin tu tadi, dengkah Tuhan pada lama tinggal.
We long for a spiritual connection to a spiritual being.
Kita selalu ke ngigo utai ke roh-roh deh. Kita selalu ke ngigo ke bekenyo. Lepas Tuhan nang udah ngkahnya pada lama tinggal. Yang buat tadi kita bisik deh, Esmeral. Nya kebuah tadi kita bisik ngikok Tuhan tu, kita bisik ngikok kerampok, bisik lepas kita ikut bisik nampul ke Tuhan. Kita ngikok siapa Tuhan kita?
Hey.
That is why people believe in a higher power.
Nya kebuah kita mensia tu Arab ngagai kuasa ti besar, lebih besar dari kita.
You believe in magic?
Kita percaya ngagai magic ne? Percaya sila betul. Ngagai roh-roh.
We have been created as such. It is who we are.
Kita itu nang digagok Tuhan bekenyok.
And that's why Jesus is here.
Nyok kepada Tuhan Yesus bisik itu.
Amen.
Amen.
And so, when Jesus sees our pains and our sufferings,
nama Jesus mendak pemedias kita ngah penusah kita.
He knows we long for healing.
Ya nemu kita itu berguna ke pengerai. Okay, pengerai kita lu gerai sakit kayaknya berarti ya pengerai tubuh rohani roh kita.
He has placed it in our hearts to long for Him.
Tuhan tak ngengkah ke pengerindu nyok pada lama ti. Pengerindu ngigo Tuhan.
But we are selfish and we are scared.
Tak kita selalu takut, kita selalu penting kita rimpu aja. Berundang kita rimpu kita.
We are scared of the world.
Kita takut ke dunia.
What people would think of us.
Nama runding orang kita.
We are scared of the consequences of our sins.
Kita takut nama dekatnya di dah kita berdosa.
You are scared to fall ill, to have a sickness if you mistreat your body.
Kita bukan takut nanti kita not nyakot tubuh kita lalu sakit.
So when we fall so far into a sin,
bayang kita sudah terlalu jauh dalam dosa.
Sometimes we think there is no more saving.
Kita pun kadang berunding, kadang boleh diselamatkan lagi. Sudah terlalu dosa.
But Jesus can do anything for you.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus is gentle.
Tuhan Yesus lembut.
And He is our healer.
Yeah,
amen. Amen.
He wants to help you.
Ya kan ulung nuan.
Even if you believe you don't deserve it.
Ada perang ngasai ke derimpu nuan not layak.
Just like that woman.
Sebab induk kebutang tadi.
Who was ready to die.
Udah bersedia ke mati ya.
But Jesus says.
Tak Jesus mandah.
You have a new life.
Nuan mesti pergi hidup baru.
Amen.
You have a new life.
Nuan mesti pergi hidup baru.
We must allow Jesus to heal us.
Kita mesti membenar ke Tuhan Yesus ngerai kita.
Things that we have done or have been done to us in the past.
Orang utai ke dalam lo, utai seminat ngadusa kita yang putang. Ari ulah rabukai, ari jaku rabukai ke kita subo. Nyok medes ke kita nyok. Jaku orang ke mana? Orang yang bedok kita berdegi kita bersumpah kita nyok megok Tuhan.
They are painful and they are real.
Utai itu tadi medias kan wan, ngutai itu amatnya deh.
They are real to you.
Utai itu amat kan wan.
And Jesus wants to come to you and to tell you. Oh, Jesus wants us to come to Him.
Jadi Tuhan Yesus ke kita datang ngagayo.
He wants us to tell Him our pains.
Kita ikut kita yang pun madangnya Tuhan pemedias kita.
Even though He already knows.
Saja pun dia dah nemu pemedias kita.
But He wants to hear it from His children.
Tangnya kok ningo jakunya hari anak yo.
Don't you want to hear what your children are going through in their day?
Kita menjadi kapai kok kena kita ningo nama nak terjadi buat anak-anak kita tiap-tiap hari ni kita nama anak kita jatuh kita ningo maka.
be it the joys or the pains.
Kadang-kadang balon anak kita mesti madah pedes, mesti madah teh ke mana, mesti madah teh ke gago.
Yes. And because it's important, they are precious to you. Your children are precious to you.
Anak tu tadi pun berga buat kita.
So are you that are precious to God?
Begitu mega nuan berga ke Tuhan.
I have this verse in Romans 8.
Roma bagi 8.
It says, there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah. Roma bagi 8:1, imadahnya alai dia tu orang ke dalam Jesus Kristus nadai kena hukum lagi.
For the law of the Spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sin and death.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Apaan adat roh ti meri penghidup dalam Jesus Kristus udah ngelepas ke aku ari adat dosa ngau pemati.
For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do.
Laban Allah Taala udah ngerejo utai ti no uleh dikerejo adat laban mensia lemi.
By sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh.
Nya alai yang ngirum ke anak yampu, ngenak gambar mengsio ti berdosa, ngamik ke yang muai dosa, ngukum dosa dalam tubuh mengsio.
In order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Ngamik ke atur ti lurus di baik adat di kamat ke dalam kitai kehidup nitiah ke penekak Roh Kudus ukai penit ukai nitiah ke penekak mensio.
For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace.
Amen.
Lapan orang ke hidup nitiah ke penekak mensio, berunding ke utai ti dikingin ke mensio. Tang orang ke hidup nitiah ke penekak Roh Kudus, berunding utai ti dikedekak ke Roh Kudus. Runding ti ditumpu ke ngagai penekak mensio, nuju ngagai mati. Tarunding ti ditumpu ke ngagai penekak Roh Kudus nuju ngagai penghidup ngau pemayat.
God has given us his Spirit.
Tuhan udah merikkan Roh Kudus dengan kita.
To turn away from the sins of the world.
Lah kita boleh ngelengkok ke dosa.
To have the strength to turn away.
Bisi pengering lah kita boleh ngelengkok ke dosa.
And to live in the Spirit.
Alah hidup buat dalam Roh.
For he says that you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear.
Kita nak terima roh pemati. Tinggungkung kita hari dosa.
But you have received the spirit to be called, to be adopted as sons of God.
Tang kita udah terima roh kudus.
Amen.
Kita udah dikangau.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you cry, Abba, Father.
Maya menyebut apa yang kami di serga.
When you cry Jesus.
Maya menyebut Jesus.
He will be here to help you.
Ya ditu bisi nolong kita.
And he is here to heal you.
Ya bisi mengkau datai ke ngeriak ngerai kenuan.
To bring you out of your pain and your suffering.
Kena keluar kena lari pemedias nanya tadi.
The Lord loves you.
Tuhan rindu kenuan.
And he sees you.
Yang mendawan.
He knows your pains.
Yang ngelalau pemedias Tuhan.
And he wants you to tell him.
Ya kok Tuhan kok Tuhan mandah ngeri.
The world goes through different kinds of pains.
Dunia mayuh macam pemedias.
And it is all important to the Lord.
Ya. Buat Tuhan tanya pemayuh pemedias tu nyadi Tuhan. Bagi Tuhan utai tu besar pemuai.
And I pray that in your prayers.
Yang harap kemeh kita bersampai.
That you will surrender.
Lakan menyerah ke.
Your sins.
Dosa nuan.
Your sufferings.
Penusah nuan. Pemedias
nuan. And give it to the Lord.
Beri bagi Tuhan.
Because he does not condemn you.
Lepas ini nak hukum nuan.
He is not here to say that you are wrong. And there is no more saving for you. But he says that you are welcome.
Tuhan Yesus mandang nuan diterima.
And that he loves you.
Ya rindu ke nuan.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Think about what the woman just said to us.
Nampak tidak pada hidupnya tadi ni kita.
The very people that wanted to destroy her.
Orang tidak kau menuah ya tadi.
It's like the devil.
Yes, bakal setan.
He came to steal and to kill and to destroy.
Jadi nyok Tuhan, penguasa setan tidak tadi jadi nama jadi pencuri, menuah dan rusak.
But though their plan was evil.
Tajak pun rancangan sedangnya jahil.
God used it for good.
Tuhan guna nukarnya jadi ke mana?
She was brought to the only one who could help her.
Induk tu tadi dibayar dengan si kujung orang tu leh nolong dia.
Everything that has happened in your life.
Namo tidak nyadi pada lampung hidup nuan.
Hey, has brought you to the one who can help you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Amen. He won't condemn you.
Tuhan nak hukum tuan.
For he has promised.
Lapan sudah bersemayo.
Whoever comes to me.
Siapa datang ke gayo?
I will not turn away.
Aku nak akan melengkap orang tu.
Oh hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us all stand to our feet.
Kita semua berdiri.
Stand.
Berdiri megang kita.
Hallelujah.
Kita kena berdiri.